What's up guys, it's your boy Damone, and welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. Today we're going to be talking about Child, and whether or not he's really worth your time. I'm going to explain to you the ins and outs. We've done a lot of testing, what I think the best weapons for him, whether or not he's good at Constellation 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way throughout and through, and then we're going to talk about where he kind of fits into a team composition, in my opinion. Now what you guys are looking at here is a level 90 Child. I've been saving materials. We've been getting a lot of people coming into the stream asking me, like, D, how come you ain't leveled up any of your characters, yada yada yada, how come nobody's level 90 after you hit adventure rank 50? Yes, for the record, I am adventure rank 50, almost 51, but the reason why is because I've been focusing purely on this guy. So what we got him going on with right now is a Skyward Harp with refinement rank 1, but arguably I still think Rust, which is a 4-star weapon, is going to be better, unless of course you have a Skyward Harp, which is max refinement. But if you have Rust, I think Rust is definitely the safer choice, but we'll get into that here in a little bit and talk about some other weapons as well. He is currently at 0 constellation at the start of this video. As we go through from beginning of the video to the end of the video, we'll get him all the way to 6, and we'll talk about what happens at each of these phases. These are his talent levels at 6, 6, and 6. His passive obviously makes it to where he increases your own party member's normal attack level by 1, so he's just perfect for maximizing your DPS for your basic attack no matter who you're using in your party. But overall, I think that Child can absolutely be a beast, but he's going to be very, very, very polarizing. With Child, you guys are either going to love this character or you're going to hate him. Now, what Child is he's basically an archer that deals some, you know, decent damage. And then when you press E, he turns into a melee attacking monster with some decent attack speed, where all of your bow stats, bonuses, all that stuff will definitely apply to his melee attacks. Now, when we get into his first ability, guys, he does 6 consecutive shouts. We're not going to talk too crazy about this because we already talked a lot about Child and really, you know, what he does in the previous video where I said, should you summon or save? What I do want to talk about, though, is this Riptide effect that will be where a majority of your damage from Child comes from. Opponents that are affected by Riptide will suffer AoE Hydro damage effects when attacked by Tartaglia in various ways. Damage dealt in this way is considered normal attack damage. So Riptide Flash, a fully charged aim shot that hits an opponent affected by Riptide, deals consecutive bouts of AoE damage, can occur once every 0.7 seconds. Riptide Burst, an opponent affected by Riptide creates a Hydro Burst that inflicts the Riptide status on nearby enemies hit. Now in the beginning, for those of you guys, let's say, are just getting Child, you don't have any talents, you don't have any level ups, you basically apply Riptide by using your charged attack. Once you apply Riptide to a target, you'll notice it by like the little symbol there that they have on their chest. This is where you'll start to see the extra damage effects come into play, and the beautiful thing about this is if you mark an assassin like this, you can see here, you can notice wherever he's at. Now when you switch to his melee, the same thing is going to apply, and it's going to stack those consistent Riptide effects. Now when we get into his first talent that you get at his ascension, it extends the Riptide duration by 8 seconds. Once you get into his Sword of Torrents, basically what happens is if you're in a melee stance or if your normal and or charge attacks do crit damage, so basically if you have crit damage or you apply a crit, they will apply the Riptide status effect on an enemy. At this point it becomes a lot easier to DPS with Child just due to the fact that now you can put this effect up pretty much permanently on an enemy if you're using Child in any way, shape, or form to land critical attacks, so on and so forth. Now, one thing I did want to mention about his Raging Tide, because this is basically his melee stance here, is every time you enter your melee, your attacks turn into Hydro damage, but they do share the bonus effects of whatever bow you're using. So if you're using a Skyward Harp, right, you get the extra crit damage plus the AoE extra attack. If you're using Brust, you get the, you know, the bonus attack damage. Stringless, the increased skill damage, so on and so forth. And we were able to test all of these on stream when we first pulled Child. While you're in the stance, and this is really, really important for my peeps out there that are just going to be running C0 or Constellation 0 Child, is that you have to really pay attention to the 30 seconds timer that Child is in his stance. So while he's in this stance, you have a certain amount of time to deal as much damage as you can. Granted, you can leave it and go longer than 30 seconds, but if you don't turn this cooldown off on your own, the cooldown will be dramatically longer than it would be otherwise. So the kicker is, especially if you guys are running Child at C0, is you guys can kind of really play with dancing as an archer, being an archer, shooting shots, you know, swapping in between your E, and then popping right back out and then switching back to range mode and kind of juggling, or what we used to call in World of Warcraft, if you guys from my World of Warcraft tank players, we call the stance dancing, right? So really just getting familiar with using archery and or melee combat and intermingling of the two. So if you prefer range combat, you definitely can stay back and focus on your charged attacks and your basic attack spam, as long as, again, you keep applying that effect, that Riptide effect, then that's one way that you can go about it. Or if you guys prefer to stay in a melee stance longer, then you guys can definitely rely on this. But again, just make sure you guys are keeping an eye out for the 30-second cooldown so you guys know exactly what's going on. But just keep in mind that as your constellations increase, your playstyle definitely could change. Now, before we get into constellations, let's talk a little bit about gear, and we'll start that by talking about weapons. Now, there's a couple of weapons that I want to point out here. If you guys are looking at putting them on Favonius for the energy recharge, that's definitely something you guys can look at for old spam. Let's say if this is the only warbow that you guys have because you got this from completing quests and you want to use this, by all means, go for it. Now, in terms of maximizing damage, we tested a bunch of different iterations. We got into stringless, where I wanted to see, okay, at the time, because my Rust was level 50, and then my stringless was almost level 50, so I wanted to look at refinement 5 versus refinement 5 on both of these weapons. Stringless fell a little bit short from hitting the mark. Mind you, I think stringless could definitely shine if you're focusing more on getting elements of mastery, especially if you're pairing child with characters like Delug, Klee, and you're trying to maximize on that water over fire vaporized damage. It could also be really, really good if you guys are rocking with like a hydro bonus damage cup as well, if you guys are trying to maximize the elemental damage he's dealing on either his charge shots and or his melee attack spam. However, Rust definitely could be the bow that you're looking for, and the reason I say that is because even at level 50 when we were testing this on stream, Rust was easily out DPSing Skyward Harp at refinement rank 1. So what I went ahead and did was leveled up the bow before we started the video to level 90. So you guys can see a level 90 5-star refinement 1 weapon versus a level 60 Rust bow. And then you guys can make the determination on your own. So first up, guys, we're going to be looking at the level 90 bow. So we're going to hit E here. You guys can see the numbers, you know, 3,000 there, right? We got another 3K, 3260, right? You guys can see the numbers pretty easily. But now we're going to get into Rust, and I'll talk about some drawbacks here and some potential things that you guys will face. But I'll show you guys the difference between the numbers, okay? So obviously the challenge here is that my crit rate is quite a bit lower, but you guys are seeing very similar numbers in terms of Rust, right? At refinement 5, we use the stuff here. You guys are seeing the same types of damage on a refinement 5 Rust that you're seeing literally on a level 90 5-star, you know, Skyward Harp, versus a level 60 Rust at refinement rank 5. So the same kind of a principle applies here, where if you guys are using like, you know, max refined 3-star weapons early on to kind of give yourself a jump, you know, it's going to give you a little bit more of a boost. Now granted, if you guys have a max refined Skyward Harp, obviously please use the Skyward Harp. But in this situation, if you guys only have access to Rust, but Rust, in my opinion, is easily one of the best choices for child if you guys are looking for a way to easily put up some numbers and not really have to worry about spending a ton of money to get a 5-star bow or rely on a crazy amount of luck to get the 5-star bow either if you guys happen to have Rust. Now, in terms of the craftables, guys, if you guys are wondering about, you know, compound bow and or prototype crescent, it's really going to boil down to your playstyle. So if you guys are focusing more on spamming attacks, right, or you guys want to maximize your melee DPS for like increasing the normal attack speed, then I would say go with compound bow, especially with the physical damage bonus, because this is going to increase your basic attacks quite substantially. All right. Now, keep in mind, though, that the physical damage bonus is not going to affect your dagger attacks because those are pure hydro damage, right? But your basic shots and stuff like that will definitely be affected by the physical damage bonus. So for attack spam, I think compound bow can be best. Now, for those of you guys who like to snipe and you guys are doing range shots, you guys like to aim and focus on weak points, then obviously prototype pressing would be the choice. But I feel like a easier choice if you guys are just trying to get into the fight and just go ham, I think compound will probably take the cake in terms of craftables. In terms of artifacts, I've been trying to play with a lot of different stuff. I've been playing with Wanderer's Troop, I've been playing with Gladiator, and I've also been playing with Nobless Oblige. These three are probably striking me the most. Again, unless you guys are looking to go for more of a physical damage bonus here, then you guys can maybe like go with like a two set Bloodstained Chivalry, or like a two set, you know, Gladiator stack with like a two set Nobless if you guys are trying to maximize your elemental burst damage. Or pretty much anything, for that matter, I think is the best way to go, as long as you focus some primary stats that I think Child are going to need, in my opinion. Now, as we get into ideal builds, guys, I talked to you guys a little bit about artifacts and what sets I would look for. It's just kind of tough right now because we don't have a Hydro bonus damage set, because ultimately, I think, in my opinion, I would probably build Child on Hydro bonus damage. Now, the reason I say that is because, especially if you guys are going for a Constellation 6, because of the amount of time that you're going to be using your deck for the Hydro damage, Hydro bonus damage, I think, is what's going to allow you to deal as much damage as possible. So if you guys are able to find a cup with Hydro bonus damage and you guys are going for a higher constellation and or lower cooldown Child, then Hydro bonus damage could be the way that you could go. However, if you guys aren't looking for Hydro bonus damage on the cup, or if you guys are not going for higher constellations, you guys are just using a C0 Child, as you guys saw maybe in my stream that you guys saw me play with all day, I'd recommend going for more of an attack percent build here, an attack percent build on your pocket watch, and probably a crit damage helmet if you guys are able to get your crit rate high enough, basically above 50%. If you guys are unable to get the above 50%, then obviously you guys can go with like an attack build, you know, just for safety's sake, and you guys can continually and gradually improve your gear over time. Now, I think in terms of Child, he needs crit rate, crit damage, elemental mastery, and energy recharge. Like, those four stats, hands down, are the best. The reason why I'm going to explain to you is because you want the crit anyway, because it's going to increase the amount of times you deal crit damage, so you guys can keep the Riptide effect that he applies on top of your enemies, right? Which is going to maximize your DPS. You want elemental mastery because if you're chaining with Child using pretty much any other type of element, and then you're finishing combos with Child because he is a primary DPS or primary damage dealer, you want to make sure that he's maximizing his reaction damage. So you want your elemental mastery through your subs, not through a main stat, all right? And then the energy recharge, of course, because you want to minimize the amount of time that it takes for you to get your ult up, especially if you guys are looking at getting into constellations later. Now we're going to summarize the difference between C0 all the way up to C6. I'm going to talk about each of the phases to kind of help give you guys an idea of where you should be aiming towards if you guys are summoning for duplicates. All right, so when we look at his first constellation, the big thing is that Constellation 0, Child is more focused on managing your cooldown times and really paying attention to when to switch to a bow, when to switch to melee, you know, dancing back and forth so you can manage your times. Constellation 1 is going to attribute to that, and it's going to help you out quite considerably. So in a situation where, let's say, you just all out going crazy, spamming your melee attacks and trying to deal as much damage as you possibly can, when you swap out, this is going to dramatically reduce the amount of time that it takes for you to be able to use your E again. Although Constellation 1 is nice, I don't feel like you're going to see that much of a difference, although the cooldown time can help. And if you guys are more into Child because you have the option to melee and you want to melee more often, Constellation 1 can be nice to get. Once we get into Constellation 2, this is where things start to get a little bit interesting and you get a lot more emphasis on his melee attacks. Because once you get into Constellation 2, when opponents affected by Riptide are defeated, Tartaglia or Child regenerates 4 elemental energy. So for those of you guys who are running with like a sacrificial bow, or if you guys are trying to get recharged through substats, overall this is going to really help you like speed up that time it takes for you to get your ult up again to keep spamming. So case in point here, I'm going to pop my E. We're going to go ahead and finish this guy off, and you guys can kind of see the energy recharge kind of come back to play as we kill an enemy. Now keep in mind that you only need 60 energy to use this ult, and his cooldown is pretty low, so you could definitely set him up and use him even more efficiently around Constellation 2. Constellation 3 is basically just a skip, but just increases his skill value and obviously his damage output. And Constellation 4 is where we start to get into the craziness. So if Tartaglia is in Raging Tide's melee stance, he triggers Riptide Slash against opponents on the field affected by Riptide every 4 seconds. Otherwise, he triggers Riptide Flash. Riptide Slashes and Riptide Flashes triggered by this Constellation effect are not subject to the time intervals that would typically apply to these two Riptide effects, nor do they have any effect on those time intervals. So as we get into Constellation 4, this is where we're really going to be maximizing DPS for Child. So if you have Riptide applied to a bunch of enemies on the field, this is something that every 4 seconds, like, the damage is just going to tick. And you guys see how this is just ticking here? I can just run around and I can just wait. And this is going to take your damage output to the next level, especially if you guys are rocking with some pretty solid gear. This can be especially helpful if you have characters that you're trying to mix, you know, elements with and create team synergy. Riptide actually procs from his Constellation 4. What that's going to do is it's going to also trigger the elemental reactions, where if you guys are building an elemental mastery build, you guys can maximize on the reaction damage there as well. Even better for those of you guys who prefer to use Ranged Child, because then you can ult a group of enemies, apply Riptide to all of them, and then you can let them take the periodic damage over time that you guys can see there. Once we get into Constellation 5, this is just another skill upgrade for more damage, of course. And then when we get into C6, this is when Child becomes the man. This is where he's going to be able to melee forever. Because what this does is, as we get this here, it'll activate. When Havoc Obliteration is cast in melee stance, the cooldown for Raging Tide is reset. This effect will only take place once Tartaglia returns to his range stance. So how this works is basically I can just get my E, get into my E stance. I can just smash, smash, pow, 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 kill everything, you know, deal as much damage as I can with my little level 60 rust that I'm using right now. And then once my ult regenerates, I ult, right? And then when I change back into my form, it automatically resets my cooldown. So now I can switch back to melee again. Attack again, boom, generate my ult again, right? And as long as I get back in cooldown, you see my ult is already back up again. I ult, boom, I use it again, 24,000 crit, and then switch back, and boom. My cooldown is right back to zero, and I can just keep juggling this and juggling this and juggling this and juggling this for all eternity to kill as many targets as I want to kill. Child, I think, is a magnificent hero, but like I said, he's very, very, very polarizing, and what you think about him is just going to depend on whether or not you like to play the hero or not. I think he has great team utility just because of the fact that he can apply Riptide, and with the Riptide, you can combine down with elemental effects, not to mention his passive increases the basic attack talent of your entire party while he's in a team. Child, I think, was meant to be a primary damage dealer, although he can offer some support due to the fact that his bow ult is ranged and it has a pretty decent radius. All in all, I think that Child is a very, very, very versatile hero that can fit into a lot of different team comps depending on what you want to do. If you want to put him with Diona, if you want to put him with Lisa, Kachin, any fire hero, pretty much any type of team composition, I think he could really be strong. Even if you wanted to pair him with like Mona to maximize the ult damage, whatever you want to do, the sky is the limit. He's very capable of using a number of weapons, and then you would just have to set up your build strategy around what weapon and what strategy and or playstyle you guys prefer to use. If you prefer range focus, then focus your gear around that. Focus more on the Wanderer's Troop with charge attack and or potentially a Amos bow if you guys are able to get that. Or if you guys are focused more on the melee attacks, then focus all of your gear sets around that accordingly. Now, hopefully this video covered pretty much any question you could ask about this particular hero. We spent a lot of time really tinkering with Child and playing with him and seeing how he worked, just all in all, testing all his abilities, testing him at Constellation 0, playing with him at Constellation 6 now that you guys are seeing with me here in the video, and really just trying to play with all types of different things in team synergy. One thing I do want to mention before I bring this to a close, he does not work well with Chong Yun. It works very well with other ice heroes, though, like Kaya. I did want to throw that out there. But if you guys got any other questions, comments, concerns about this particular hero, definitely let me know in the comment box below, and I'd be happy to assist. And with that being said, we will see you guys in the next video. Peace.